So Mont Blanc just released another flanker from the Legend line. Is this fragrance going to be better than the rest? Stay tuned to find out. So today's fragrance is going to be another unboxing first impressions update video. This time it comes from the house of Mont Blanc and is their latest release, Legend Eau de Parfum. So Legend Eau de Parfum from the house of Mont Blanc is a men's leather fragrance released in 2020. The nose behind this fragrance is Olivier Pichot and is an Eau de Parfum concentration. Alright, let's check out the presentation. So here's the box for Legend Eau de Parfum. If you guys are familiar with the line, this box is almost identical to the other ones. We just have some gold piping here, some gold lettering. It does say Mont Blanc in white here, and it does have their insignia for their company. Has it also on top. Other than that, not too much going on with this box. Let's check out the bottle. So here's the bottle for Mont Blanc Eau de Parfum. Again, if you guys are familiar with the line, this is the exact same shape of the bottle. This one does look a bit different. I will say I do like this one out of all the rest from the line. This does have like a nice glass sort of outlining here, as you can see here at the bottom, and sort of along the sides. It does look like the inside of the bottle is painted black, which I think is a really nice look. We do have the Mont Blanc insignia here. Right here, and it does say Mont Blanc in gold across the cap here. This cap is metal with plastic on the inside. Black atomizer. Nice bottle from the house, Mont Blanc. All right, so here are the notes for Legend Eau de Parfum. In the top, we have violet leaves and bergamot. In the mid, we have woody notes, magnolia, and jasmine. And in the base, to round things off, was leather and oak moss. Yeah, so I do have a little bit of experience with the house of Mont Blanc. I've bought quite a few of their fragrances over the years. And also when it comes to the Legend line, I have tried the original and I have tried the Intense. I believe that one came in the dark gray bottle. I've tried Legend Spirit. I believe that was in the white bottle. And then there was Legend Night, which I think might be my favorite of all of the Legend line because that one was... just a very date night fragrance, very very sexy fragrance. I can't remember exactly what notes are in it, but it was very sexy and very dark and just very sexy overall. But the problem was that the performance was terrible with that fragrance. I wish it lasted longer. They would have a hit. They should make a Mont Blanc Legend Night Intense or Extreme or something, or an Eau de Parfum like this one. Again, but going back to the Legend, I wasn't a big fan of those. Now, I do like the smell of it. I believe those... reminded me quite a bit of Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce and or Vodka on the Rocks from Killian. It just has that that fierce sort of DNA. And the Mont Blanc Legend, the Intense and the original both had the same DNA. The Intense was okay. You know, it smelled a little bit stronger, but honestly, the performance was subpar on both of those fragrances. And I believe the Intense was a little bit better. I mean, it's an Intense. It's going to be a little bit better, but not nearly what I was hoping for. When I saw that there was an Eau de Parfum version that was released recently, I jumped at the opportunity. Actually, I think I just saw it yesterday online. I can't remember if I just saw it on the Dillard's website or something, but I went and picked it up as soon as I saw they were selling this. Went to my local mall and picked it up. I believe it's $110. They are offering a 15% discount right now, but that's probably going to be over soon. So I think 100 mils is about $110. Not really sure if that's worth it, obviously, just yet. But let's give this fragrance a first impression. All right, here we go. Clean hand. I do recall these atomizers spraying a lot of juice, so hopefully we'll get the same... experience. Decent amount. Okay, immediately getting that Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce DNA. Don't know exactly what makes that DNA up, but right now I'm getting a lot of the bergamot and the violet leaves right on top. Those are the top notes, obviously, but I'm just saying, like, I'm getting them quite a bit. It's very fresh. Citrusy. The violet leaves are giving a bit of greenness. I'm definitely getting that bergamot, that fresh bergamot opening, fruity and fresh. And the violet leaves in this, there's a fragrance that I tried recently that has violet leaves in it, and it smells pretty close to this, these violet leaves, I guess, in this fragrance. But right now it's not changing too much from there. Getting the woody notes, Those are very prominent in this. Right now, this one isn't as heavy or as thick as I thought it was going to be. When I hear Eau de Parfum, I guess I just think it's going to be thick. Not getting any of the leather either just yet. Although it is getting a bit darker. I was just saying how it was very fresh. And I was hoping it was going to get darker. I was thinking it was going to get darker. But wasn't at first, but it is sort of now. Right now, this one's very fresh, though. Way fresher than I thought it was going to be. Violet leaves, bergamot, woody notes for sure. I'm sure the jasmine and magnolia are in there somewhere. The moss for sure, because I'm getting a green touch. Not nearly as leathery as I thought it was going to be. Online, this was considered a leather fragrance. I'm not really getting that right now. Obviously, it's in the base, so it's going to be in the dry down. So I'm sure that's going to be like your kind of heavier, dusty, sometimes can be sexy leather note. But right now, getting the Fierce, Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce, or just the original Legend DNA, which it comes to be expected. That's what it's supposed to smell like. It is an Eau de Parfum version of Legend. I mean, right now, it does smell like it's a little bit stronger. Obviously, time's going to tell. Not hating on this one right now. I mean, it does smell to be a little bit stronger, a stronger version of the original. I can't see this offending anybody. It's very pleasant. It does have that DNA though. So if I didn't, you know what Legend was, I would definitely say this smells like Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce. That fragrance gets a lot of compliments though. That fragrance is a legend in Fragcom for a reason. And I do want to get my hands on Fierce Intense. That one apparently is pretty hard to come by, and it's they're asking a lot for it online. Yeah, but right now, this is a nice fragrance. Definitely think it's a stronger version of the original, which is what I was expecting. Although sometimes with some of these houses, they'll put Eau de Parfum and it'll be a completely different fragrance. They'll add all new notes and might keep a little of that DNA in there. This one actually does just smell like a stronger version of the original. Now, I don't have the original on hand. I don't have the Intense on hand either. But as far as memory serves, this does remind me of a stronger version of the original. And this isn't a bad fragrance. It's actually kind of nice. It's a lot fresher than I thought it was going to be. You know, I saw the black bottle and I saw how it's like jet black on the inside. I really thought this was going to be very thick and heavy and masculine and, you know, evening wear only kind of thing. This one started off pretty fresh. But right now, it's very fresh. It's green and it's woody. Yeah, after a few minutes, it's definitely getting nice. Still not getting a predominant leather note in this. Maybe it's just like a lighter dusty leather, but it's not. I'm not getting any kind of leather that's definitely standing out at the moment. I'm getting a lot of creamy woods now. The citrus notes are in there, the violet leaves, and the woody notes are nice and creamy, slightly green. I'm definitely thinking this is going to be a nice fragrance in the warmer weather, and it's probably heavy enough for the cooler weather too, maybe, you know, early spring and fall. But I definitely think this might shine in the summertime as well, because I'm not seeing this one being heavy. It's very fresh and just a nice fresh fragrance, and we'll see what, you know, time will tell. But I'm starting to like the dry down of this fragrance. It's getting a lot sexier. Don't know where that's coming from, honestly, guys. It's getting sweeter and like slightly creamy and woody. Almost a bit of a plasticky kind of smell in there. It's not a deal breaker for me though. I'm just getting it. I'm just being transparent here with you guys. Getting a slight plastic smell. Not sure where that's coming from, but again, it works with it, if that makes any sense. Yeah, but I like this fragrance so far, and I'm going to wear it over the next few days and give you guys an update shortly. Talk to you then. All right, well, I'm back with my update for Legend Eau de Parfum from the House of Mont Blanc. Yeah, so I spent the last couple days with this fragrance, and I gotta say, I do really like this fragrance. Now, it does come down to one main thing, that if you guys like the original Legend, you're gonna love this fragrance. And then you guys can go back to plenty of previous videos where I've said that all I want in some of these Eau de Parfums or Intense or Extreme versions is I just want it to smell like the original. just a stronger concentration. Now, don't get me wrong, every now and then they'll come up with a new formula that actually smells the same but better, but not too much like the old formula. But this one here is just, to my nose anyway, I didn't have them side by side, but to my nose, to my memory, smells just like the original, just stronger, which I think was the biggest problem with that fragrance. And finally, you know, this one has been compared to, or Montblanc Legend has been compared to Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce, or Vodka on the Rocks, but I think, honestly, I didn't have them side by side, but this one honestly reminds me more of Percival from the House of Parfums de Marly. Now, yes, this one does smell like the original, don't get me wrong, but just the strength of it and, yeah, pretty much just the strength of this DNA really reminded me of Percival from the House of Parfums de Marly. So if you guys like that fragrance, you're going to like this one. Longevity for this fragrance, well, compared to the old fragrance, like I said, it only lasted a couple of hours. This fragrance gets excellent longevity. I got 8 hours every time I wore this fragrance. Now, it wasn't a beast by any means, but for a fresh fragrance, it really did take the cake in that department. Definitely did. It got what I was hoping it would get. It got really good longevity, which is definitely better than the original. Projection for this fragrance, well, this is an Eau de Parfum, but it's also a designer, you know, so, you know, you go in expecting you're going to get decent projection because it is an Eau de Parfum, but then again, you've been burned in the past because a lot of designers will put, you know, the EDP label on a fragrance and it doesn't get very good projection. But I will say, you don't get excellent projection, but you do get above average projection for a designer EDP. I will give it that much. The first 2 hours, like most fragrances, were the strongest, but this one was a little bit stronger than most freshies that you get. I was really surprised by that. I was actually very happy with the projection with this fragrance because, I mean, I got a pretty decent little scent cloud for the first couple of hours, and I really got decent wafts off me in the first couple of hours. Now, I got wafts throughout the days, but the first couple of hours are going to be the best. Seasons for this fragrance, well, initially I thought it was going to be the warmer months of the year, but the more I wore this one, the more I was really impressed by the performance of it and how thick and woody it was. It had a nice bite to it. You know, the citrus notes, initially I was like, okay, it's going to be a freshie, but man, it just hung around and it got decent projection as well. So I think, you know, you should be able to get by using this fragrance through all seasons. Occasions for this fragrance, well, again, I thought this fragrance was going to be best for casual day wear, but the more and more that I wore it, you know, I found myself wearing this one in the evening time as well and thought, man, this is a pretty sexy fragrance. So it does open up nice and fresh and zingy with the, you know, the bergamot note and the violet note with those woody notes, but man, it is a lot heavier than the original, and everyone knows that everyone likes that Abercrombie & Fitch Fierce DNA. A lot of women thought that fragrance was sexy, and that DNA still is really sexy, so I definitely think you can probably pull this fragrance off for all occasions. I think you can wear this one to work if you go easy on the trigger. Probably not strong enough for a club, but I think it's good enough for all occasions. Ages for this fragrance, well, the younger guys could easily pull this fragrance off because it does have that fierce DNA, but this one is a bit more mature, a little slightly more mature, slightly heavier version of that, and I do think that the 25 and up year old crowd would really appreciate that slight more matureness to kind of take it out of that juvenile range. Also, it's more expensive. I believe this is $110 for a 100ml bottle. You know, if the younger guys can wait a while, let the price go down a little bit, they can afford this one, but I definitely think right now 25 and up would be a good age range for this fragrance. So overall, I do really like this fragrance. It is a stronger version of the original, and that's sort of how I'm gauging this one. It's not original by any means because it's already been done before, but if you're looking at this one through a lens of, hey, I like the original Legend, it just didn't last long enough, you know, it was gone after a couple of hours, then this is gonna be your fragrance. This fragrance has that DNA, just better performance, plain and simple. If you like that fragrance, but it didn't have the performance, grab this one. Now, right now, we'll say it's a bit expensive. $100 to $110 for a 100ml bottle, I believe, is what I paid for it. If you wait a while, it's probably going to be a year before it hits, like, Marshall's, you know, to pick it up in your local store. Maybe you can wait then. Maybe 6 months for it to get, you know, a little bit cheaper online. I would definitely wait for this one to go down in price. I wouldn't pay full retail for this one unless you just really love that DNA and you're like, screw it, I just want to get it. If you have Percival already from Parfums de Marly, you're not going to want to get this one. I think to me they're pretty similar. Again, didn't have them side by side, but they do have the same DNA. There's no point in buying those two. if you like Percival but couldn't afford it, this is going to be your guy right here, because this one still is $100. Percival is like $230, I think. Probably right now, discounted somewhere, you can probably get a tester for like $175. This one's still 100ml bottle, probably get it for less. But, you know, I do like this fragrance. I think it has that good DNA, stronger version of the original. Good performance, not going to fill up a room, not beast mode, but it's good. 8 hours of longevity, decent scent trail, decent projection for a freshie. This is a freshie on steroids, in my opinion. Again, when you smell it, oh, wow, it smells fresh. It smells woody. It smells like the original, but it's just stronger. Guys, that's the best way I can put it. I'm sort of rambling now, sort of saying the same things over and over again, but I can't say it enough that if you like the original, grab this one. Don't blind buy this one unless you just really trust my opinion on this one, knowing that it smells like the original, just stronger. But you can probably easily find this one at Macy's or at Dillard's, and you know, you can pick up a bottle and spray your hand and walk around the mall for, you know, half an hour and see if you like it, or maybe make yourself a sample. I really like this one. I think it's good. I think it's a way better version of the original. Sell your old bottles and grab this one. All right, guys, so now it's your turn. What are your thoughts on Legend Eau de Parfum from the House of Mont Blanc? If you try this fragrance, let me know your experience with this fragrance down in the comments below. All right, thank you guys so much for watching the video on my channel. If you like this video, please click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications for future first impressions videos and fragrance-related content just like this. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Dollars and Cents. There, you'll find fragrance-related photos and future contest winners. And as always, until the next video, you guys take care. Thanks.